Welcome back to the channel. I didn't think I'd be doing this again, but I was asked to, and I was told that it's better the second time. So as you can tell, we're on another toy hunt today. We're back at the 613 flea market here by Lansdowne. Lansdowne is where the Red Blacks play, football team. And I'm gonna turn the camera around. We're gonna go inside, do a walk around, see if I find anything today. You never know. All right, so here we are. We're walking in the doors. It's a lot more crowded than last time. Yeah, that booth is still there. So I guess we'll go clockwise. All right, maybe not quite clockwise. It's mostly food over there, but let's take a quick look. Well, as you can see, a lot of it is crafts, foods, clothing. But there was one guy who had toys last time. Let's see if he's back. Ah, here we go. How's it going? I won't put you on camera, don't worry. I'm on a toy hunt today. I remember you guys had some toys last time that I picked up.
What kind of toys do you like?
Mostly DC Multiverse, action figures.
Yeah. I have some, 30 each. I have some Star Trek toys.
Nah. Last time there was a couple of Green Lanterns. I remember the guy had them posted on Facebook, and I saw them all the time, so I just picked them up. For customs.
You see the guy way down there?
Yeah, I've been there before. But I figure I might as well stop here, see what you had today.
Yeah, thanks.
Ooh, what's that? Holy crap. I'm gonna pick the camera up because you know, I don't want to get the kid on camera here. And let's keep going. God, I grew up with these. Okay, the comic book vendor guy is back, but he's not as set up as last time. Once again, a lot of clothing. Vintage LPs. Alright, that's mostly food again. Okay, it is really crowded this time, but I'll skip some of the aisles so I can see where it's all clothes and jewelry, because let's be honest, we're not here for clothes and jewelry. I got a good hint that there's a good toy vendor today, so I'm gonna head over that way. Joys of toy hunting. DC Directs. Okay, I'll show you what I got later. I did pick something up. Wonderful seller. I got off stuff up in before. And he's got good prices, so not a bad deal. Not something I normally collect, but it was a good deal. That, and when you're toy hunting, you can't be too picky. You find a good deal, you pick it up. I was with these people. I went into their booth once before and I wasn't happy. They were overpriced, so. All right, well, that's it for the flea market. Okay, I just left the 613 flea market. And if being better the second time around means it was more crowded, well, that it definitely was. But if you're toy hunting, you're gonna be sorely pressed to find anything in there. I did find something, not that I know we collect, but it was a good deal. Oddly enough, the same guy bought off last time. Not something I plan on collecting, but, you know, good price. I'll pick them up. Why not? And now I'm off to the Nostalgia Warehouse, where I know I will not be disappointed. So we'll do a quick edit here, and we'll be back shortly.
Is arriving. Please stand away from the platform edge. Attention, le train en direction ouest de la station Tunney's Pasture approche. Éloignez-vous du bord du quai.
This is why I don't do too many toy hunting videos. The travel time. 10-minute bus to get to the train. Train to get all the way downtown Ottawa. Then a half-hour bus ride to get to the flea market. Half-hour bus ride from the flea market to get to the train again. And then another 15 minutes to get to this station. But this station's worth it because this is where I'm 4 blocks away from the Nostalgia Warehouse. Well, we hit the farmer's market, but we don't want that. We want this place. So as usual, I'm gonna go ask permission to film because that's the only polite thing to do. I'll be back shortly.
Just arrived at 65. Okay, is that your name? Okay, no problem. You're welcome. Bye now. Hi.
Klingons, do Klingons.
What?
It's a Klingon. Oh my god.
I won't put you on camera, don't worry.
Yeah, it's all good.
It's from my YouTube channel, so.
Right on.
My buddy in Ireland's bugging me for a close-up detail of their showcases.
Cool.
I know he's going to bug me to ask some stuff.
This place is like a time warp.
I know,
my mind's blown.
Harper reminds me of my basement for some of the
stuff.
Yeah,
yeah.
Well, it's very aptly named, like,
oh,
the God,
yeah. Oh, yeah.
I wasn't here last time, Bionic Man. Oh, frig. Ah, Evel Knievel.
Maybe not.
Holy shit. 1979 Millennium Falcon.
Yeah. I have
one here. This place is addictive. That's all I gotta say.
Oh, yeah.
I came here 2 weeks ago. I thought I'd come once a month and I'm already back.
Yeah.
have also some figures?
All right. I think it's about time that I wrap things up here. I'm going to start making my pile so I can put the camera down and start actually shopping for myself. And there's always something to find here. It's an incredible store. If you're ever in Ottawa, or if you live in Ottawa, you have to check this place out. It is amazing. Some of the things I've seen here, they weren't here last time. I'm just blown away. And you can't help it. You come in here, you think you spend 5 minutes, an hour goes by. But I'm going to start making my pile and I'll film a little thing of going home, and then I'll see you back at the House of Madness. Okay, I just walked out of there. I spent a lot more time than I wanted to in there, and of course, I blew my budget for today. Couldn't help it. You can't help it. When you're in a place like this, you can't help it. There's such good stuff to see and find. And I've also been told that I should check out this pub called the Copenhagen. So apparently they got really good food. I met the owner. He's a really nice guy. So if you go down to the Nostalgia Warehouse and you want to, well, if you want fresh food, in the month of May is the farmer's market. But well, you can't really see the sign too well. I'll flip the camera on so you get a better look at the sign. So this is the Carlton Tavern, and from what Michael read, good old Nostalgia Warehouse said, it's got really good food. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this toy hunt for today. I am dying, my back is killing me, but now it's time to walk back to the train with a rather heavy bag today, but I got some good things. And like I said, it's a great place to go to if you're vintage toy hunting, or you just even want to blow your mind with going back down memory lane. All right, see you soon. Well, it's raining again. But you know what time it is now? It's time for a travel montage. There we go.
Eastbound to Blair, direction est Blair. Next station, Lyon est Blair. Next station,
Travel montage, travel montage. Let's be lazy and take the elevator. Elevator has a very unique smell. It's a combination of hydraulic fluid and human fluid. Normally I take the stairs. Yeah. And now we wait for a bus. Yeah, one day I'm gonna have to find out where out of service goes. They have more buses going there than anywhere else. All right, let's see how bad the time is for the bus schedule. Yeah, the bus shelter smells of human fluid as well. Well, I'm not gonna film the bus ride. Suffice to say, this will end the travel montage. We'll see you back in the House of Madness. Well, I'm back in the House of Madness. I didn't go upstairs to where I normally film on the peg. I'm tired. I got a bad back. I'm UV allergic. And that trip wears me out. I'm tired. But as promised, I will show you what I brought back today. Now, the flea market, I'm telling you right now, I'm never wasting my time with that thing again. It was a waste. You know, it's bad when you go to the flea market and you end up buying from the same guy you bought last time and nothing else. It's just, you know, it's disappointing. It's disappointing. But I will show you what I picked up. And I said, as you saw in the previous video, I don't normally collect these. But just because I haven't seen them anywhere else, and it's something I've been mentioning, I picked up the DC Direct Creeper. Yes, good old Jack Ryder. Mr. McFarlane just started doing characters like this. I also picked up a vintage Brainiac. The funny thing was, I went there because last time I spoke to the guy, he told me he might have Plastic Man. He said he might even have the Manhunter. Well, he didn't. The only things he has now are Aquaman, Green Lantern, and the Ocean Master. So I don't even have to go there again, but I did like the fact that, you know, there's a Brainiac, good face sculpt, but more importantly, and I got a deal. So I can't complain too much about that, but it is, like I said, it's a big travel just to go to a flea market. Now, at Nostalgia Warehouse, I was so tempted to go in and get like a beer afterwards at that pub, a tavern I mentioned, but I don't drink beer anymore, so I've been kind of defeatist. Plus the fact I did go above my budget. Now, the reason I went over my budget wasn't because of toys. It was because something I bought for my daughter, Nicole. But she might watch this, so I don't want to show it. So you won't see what put me over budget today. But I will show you what I came home with today. I picked up... okay, comic book related, but Justice League Treasury. I picked up a Green Lantern Treasury, and of course, the Flash Treasury. Now, these normally retail for, $22. Yeah, these are on average $23 each. I didn't pay that, good deal. And it's the good old black and white treasuries, which is kind of fun to read. You don't care so much. And I did take a look at them. They are mint. They are pristine inside, which is a good little read. When I want to go back down that vintage path. I also picked up a new vendor they have there. Had some really cool patches. So I picked up a wonderful patch. But wait. I also picked up another patch. Now I just got to find a really cool jacket to put this one on. I like it. I like it. Werewolf Pistons. And I did pick up a patch, which I know my daughter is probably going to kill me for, but she's my baby, so she wants it. She's going to get it. and compared to stores that normally sell these. These are nothing. Cost next to nothing. And it's gorgeous. Look at that. This one, however, is mine. Oh, yeah, definitely mine. I did find some toys, of course, at the Nostalgia Warehouse. Oh, I will show you this. I picked this up for my niece. For some odd reason, she said she wanted a spider, so I got her a spider. Not what I'd want. I normally just squish these when we're in my house. But I picked up some stuff DC related. Not DC Multiverse. Oddly enough, Mike was nice enough to tell me that, like Marvel Legends, they come in, they go up pretty fast, especially if they're still on card. But I did pick up a couple things. He's not really poseable, but it's a nice sculpt. It's a really nice sculpt. I like the shininess of it. It's basically a desk warmer. And of course, if you're going to have the Man of Steel, you got to have. Now, the reason why I didn't collect these back in the day was I always hated the leg joints because it's a weird leg joint. I don't like it. You know, you can see it better on Supes. It's that weird, you see what I mean? It's a weird, like, leg joint. It's just weird. It's a very weird leg joint. I don't like it, but as little, you know, just desk warmers, they're nice. It's nice to have the duo. It would have been nice if they had Wonder Woman. They didn't. But in another showcase, great face sculpt. Love the details. Love the trident. I get the feeling, though, whoever had this added the chain so they wouldn't lose the trident. Just a thought. Because, I'm not going to keep the chain on, but I picked it up because it is a really nice sculpt. Once again, next to nothing. Definitely a place I do recommend. And that's it. That's my haul. The other stuff was stuff I picked up for my daughter, and you're not going to see that because that's something for her, and it's not comic book or toy related. Now, coming soon to this channel, I figure it's about time. Yep. I'm showing a box. Only because there's no window, but stay tuned to see me opening this puppy up. Thank you for watching the video. I don't normally do toy hunt videos. I definitely will not be doing a toy hunt video back to that flea market. Never again. Nostalgia Warehouse. Yeah, I'll probably go back. Probably not after 2 weeks. I'll probably wait a month and go back because it's a great place to go to. And apart from that, really not much else to do toy hunting in this town. Yesterday when I went toy hunting, I figured, okay, I'll try a couple of Walmarts. I didn't film anything because 3 Walmarts and Butkus. The only thing that they had was the Street Fighters, the ones I've already reviewed. They had those same 3 again. That's it. They had no DC Multiverse. And the funny thing was, they had almost nothing for Marvel Legends either. Their Transformer section was pathetic. And for me, I collect DC Multiverse. It was a waste of my time. Their movie section was even worse. So, yeah, I don't think I'll be doing toy hunting at Walmarts anymore. The comic book shop, like I said when I did the comic book day, great store. They don't have that much. And when I was there the other day, they're expecting stuff in June, so... And when I was at GameStop, I did stop by at GameStop to have my buddy Casey. According to all my pre-orders that I still have outstanding, they're mostly coming in August. I have no pre-orders for June. It's going to be a weird month, June. But then again, I really have to get back to finding a job. Job hunting is important. Because if I don't job hunt, how can I keep doing this? That plus the fact, I don't want to have to move to a cheaper apartment, so. Because there aren't any! That's it for now. As always, from the bottom of my broken, barely beating heart, thank you for watching the video. From the darkest, deepest recesses of my depressive soul, thank you for watching videos. Please hit like. And of course, if you haven't done it already, subscribe. Hit that little bell thing, because you don't know when that episode is going to be up. Just saying. And of course, We'll see you here no matter what next Friday night for the regular On the Peg episode. This is me, the Mad Montreal Man, just saying I am freaking beat. I'm tired. Now I have hours of editing to do. I do this for you. Oh, and Shane, I'm trying to get permission from GameStop to actually film the GameStop that I normally go to because I think it's the best GameStop that I've ever been to. But until I get permission, you're going to have to wait for that one. And until next time, you faithful fellow few, have a great weekend. Take care of yourselves. And of course, you know, do your best to stay healthy. Yeah. Don't be like Disney and rip off a concept like a flying unicorn imaginary friend, but do your best to stay happy. And even though I am sore, in pain, stressed, exhausted. Did I say stressed already? Yeah, anxiety, stressed. I always do my best, no matter what, to stay positive. And of course, best way to do that is when you have toys. See you next time. Thank you.